Hi everyone. So here's some very interesting news coming out of the incestuous relationships of, well, the chip manufacturers really. So you'll remember that the Samsung Galaxy S6 was originally going to launch with a Qualcomm Snapdragon 810 processor. Samsung, having evaluated the chip, decided that it wasn't up to scratch. They then went with their own processor. Now the issue here really is the Snapdragon 810 runs on a 20 nanometer process. That's basically how many transistors we can fit into a small space. The smaller that space, the cheaper chips are to produce, the less heat they produce, and so on. Now, effectively, Qualcomm has found itself with a chip design and a manufacturing process of 20 nanometers, which is literally useless. And that is why Samsung basically said, to heck with this, we're going to use our own chip, even though it was going to cost them more effectively to produce those. Now, this obviously is an interesting aspect because there is a rumour floating around this morning, which looks like less of a rumour and more like an early confirmation that Qualcomm has chosen Samsung to produce their 820 processor, the follow-on processor that we're likely to see in devices at the end of this year, early next year. The reason for this is TSMC, which is the fabrication company that Qualcomm use, is stuck basically at 20 nanometers and won't be getting down to 14 nanometers anytime soon, certainly not in the time scale that Qualcomm need for this cycle. Now, at the end of the day, we know that the 20 nanometer process from TSMC that Qualcomm have been using just isn't up to scratch. It's unfortunately generating too much heat, there's thermal throttling being required. At the end of the day, as we can see with the HTC One M9, we've got a chip there running at 1.6 gigahertz, when in theory that chip should be easily able to do 2.1 to 2.2 gigahertz, even beyond at 2.5. Unfortunately, the manufacturing process for Qualcomm this time around just hasn't worked out. And as we're now seeing, even they are switching to Samsung to be able to deliver these processors at 14 nanometers without having a complete mess like they've had with the 810. My advice to anyone who's thinking of purchasing a 810 based smartphone or tablet this year is don't. Seriously, just don't. They are not good chips at all. You'd be better off looking to some of the other manufacturers and seeing if there's a device with a Samsung Xenos chip in there, or even something like the 805 these days seems to be performing better in many respects than the 810. Heck, LG are even talking about going with the 803 processor, which I think was originally designed for tablets. It seems to be, if we can't have something that isn't made by Qualcomm, we'll take anything Qualcomm has that isn't an 810 processor. So it's going to be very, very interesting for Samsung. Essentially, they are going to be producing their own chips. They're also going to be producing all of Apple's chips, the A9 processor. And it looks like they're about to get all of Qualcomm's business as well, which essentially is everybody else. That's going to leave very few foundries out there churning out chips for anybody else at this point. Essentially, everybody's going Samsung for this next 12-month cycle by the looks of it, which is interesting because there was some talk not too long ago that for Samsung to be able to take on the A9 order from Apple, they were going to actually have to reduce their foundry usage for their own chips. Now, essentially, this means that we may very well see, or potentially have seen, a return to Qualcomm for the next Note, the Note 5. But if it turns out, as we're now expecting, that Qualcomm, Apple, and even Samsung are going to have to use their own processors and foundry work from Samsung, it could be Samsung is about to have to scale up massively with Foxconn and some of their other partners to really get these foundries humming. It could very well be Qualcomm is effectively admitting that there is just no point in taking on these 810 processors at the moment, even if it falls later on in the year and they've managed to solve some of these thermal property problems that they're having. At the end of the day, the 810 is looking like a write-off chip, and it's now full steam ahead for the 820 being produced by Samsung.